The monetary policy was a bag of shocks. First, the committee decided to hold fire and leave the repo rate unchanged. A CNBC-TV18 poll among market participants had shown that a majority, in fact, almost everybody, was expecting the sixth consecutive rate cut of at least 25 basis. But in a unanimous decision that too, the MPC decided to maintain status quo. This was not the only surprise. The market was expecting the Reserve Bank to pussyfoot on growth, not really say it as stark as that. But there was no pussyfooting. The central bank went ahead and handed a sharpest ever cut to its growth forecast, bringing it down to 5%. In fact, if you throw your mind back to February this year, the Reserve Bank had at that time projected a growth rate of 7.4% for FY20, 2019-20. Since then, it has been lowered at every policy and latest 110 basis point cut, bringing the projection to 5% now. The market was also expecting the Reserve Bank to go all out and help lift growth, thereby support the government. But in reality, the central bank made it very clear that it is as worried, in fact, more worried about inflation and maybe its own integrity. The governor warned that food inflation is likely to remain high from January to March. And the Reserve Bank and the MPC want to be sure of the trajectory of inflation to see that it is dipping before it takes any further action. What's worrying the market? The market's worry is, wow, the MPC is serious about 4% inflation target. The market had assumed that the MPC would be comfortable with a 4% plus or minus 2%, that is a 2 to 6% range. But clearly, that's not the case. Another worry for the market is the room for further rate cuts therefore limited? Is there room just for maybe one more cut? That's another worry for the market. To discuss all these and more, we are joined by an eminent panel of bankers, bond dealers and economists. P.K. Gupta, Managing Director, State Bank of India. Rajiv, Anand, Executive Director, Axis Bank. Pranjul, Bhandari, Chief India Economist at HSBC. And in a bit, Amandeep Chopra, the Head of Fixed Income at UTI Mutual Fund. Gentlemen and lady, thank you very much for joining me. Well, Pranjul, first to come to you, what's the interpretation? Are we at the end of the rate cutting cycle?
Well, look, I don't think so. I think this is a pause. You know, in retrospect, I think it's a sensible pause because the truth is that the macro package has changed quite a lot. Inflation is up now. Growth seems to have bottomed out. You know, I'm not saying there's going to be a sharp recovery, but I don't see growth falling further from here. So it's very different from the policy package that we were confronted with in the last meeting. Add to that, I think the bigger point is the credibility of the repo rate. You know, the RBI can keep cutting repo rates, but if it's not getting transmitted, it's no use. The markets always take signals from the RBI, but the RBI also has to take signals from the market. If the market is not in a position to transmit, then there is no use RBI continuously cutting the repo rate. So I think that dawned upon them, and while nobody saw this coming, in retrospect, it's not such a bad decision in my view.
Oh, I think it really makes a very good point that you can't take the RBI or the MPC for granted, and they're quite serious about the mandate handed down to them. But no, Pranjul, you're not answering my question. How many more? I mean, is the terminal repo rate 4.9 or does it go all the way to 4.65, 4.5? Has the inaction from the MPC changed further rate cut expectations for you?
I think the big thing will be how growth evolves in the next year. I think inflation will fall by the middle of next year. I sort of have a little more confidence on that. Growth is a little uncertain. At this point, we don't think that the growth revival will be anything significant. So we do have two more rate cuts in our forecast for next year in the first half of 2020.
Okay.
So we're going with two more. I have confidence on the first one, and the second one will depend on growth.
Fair enough. Now, I just want to know if the sudden inaction or the unexpected inaction has changed the perspective of the market in terms of, you know, whether the rate cuts will not be all that deep from here on. Amandeep, what would you say? Were you expecting like maybe 4.5 at the end of the rate cutting cycle, and now you think, oh no, these guys are serious about inflation, so maybe it will end at 4.9. Any change in your anticipation?
Our more or less position, this we were more or less nearing the end of the rate cut cycle. I think one more rate cut was a consensus view, and if you really look at it from a perspective of the range of expectations, it varied from as low as 15 basis point to as high as 35 basis point, right? And the larger part of the consensus was around 25 basis points. So nobody in the market believed that there would actually be a pause as far as this policy is concerned. So I think in this backdrop, the markets are recalibrating their expectations. And I think if you've seen the way the rates have reacted both in in the benchmark tenure as well as in the swap market, it does indicate that the markets are now looking at this more or less being a terminal rate. So 5.15 repo looks to be some sort of a terminal repo rate. Now, if you really went into this policy, I think 25 basis point, like I mentioned earlier, was a consensus view and already been priced in. So a 25 basis point rate cut today, even with an accommodative stance, in my view, would not have led to a very significant rally. So I've always been saying that 6.3, 6.4 is more or less a floor with a 25 basis point rate cut. And the best case scenario was maybe another rate cut down the line, possibly in the next meet. So in terms of a great upside on yields, there really wasn't much to expect. But the fact that there was nothing clearly did mean that you've seen almost a 15 to 25 basis point pullback.
Amandeep, Pranjul is still expecting two more cuts. What about you?
I think the hurdle rate for more rate cuts, I think from our perspective, are now becoming that much more difficult. The fact that the uncertainty around inflation is being cited as a key driver of today's pause, in terms of priority, clearly inflation has moved up from where growth was just in the last policy. And the amount of uncertainty which was expressed by RBI, I think that was a bit surprising, because if you looked around, even our own estimates on food inflation did indicate, the headline moving close to 5.4. But the reason why we had not sort of penciled in that high CPI headline was because I think we had modeled in some degree of intervention on the supply side to bring food inflation down, like, the government has done in the past. So I think that was the comfort which we were possibly deriving in terms of the inflation outlook. I think that now is being challenged, particularly when you have drivers of core inflation from the telecom sector. You have the automobile industry talking of a price hike given the BS6 implementation in the in the new calendar year. So I think there are certain element of risks to the upside from whatever would be the earlier assumptions of inflation.
Fair.
And that, I think, is very important.
Okay. Well, let me now get to the real economy with the bankers. Before I come to the biggest banker, Rajiv, Anand, you've been a former dealer as well. Now, are you guys also at your treasury recalibrating, as Amandeep says, how many more cuts will come? Were you all expecting that, another 50 basis could come in the next 6 months, but now you're changing your mind?
I think clearly, the RBI has not shocked, but certainly surprised the market. And I think two things have surprised me. I think it was like 100% of economists believed that there was going to be a rate cut. And we got a consensus view from the MPC that there shouldn't be a rate cut. I don't think I've seen this sort of dichotomy, in a long, long time. And I think in that sense, the fact that the MPC has decided to actually look through the weak growth numbers, but has focused his attention on one, inflation, and two, the fisc. And I think both the markets know both are issues as we go forward. I think has clearly set the benchmark, that much higher for the next rate rate cuts. But we do not believe that this is the terminal. I think, and honestly speaking, we are not really very obsessed with where the terminal rate is going to close, because of the fact that it is not clear what is going to happen to growth as we go forward, and whether the supply side will take care of inflation in the months to come. And so therefore, we do believe that there will be rate cuts from here, maybe one, maybe two, but clearly the RBI has set the benchmark for that higher.
So there is a recalibration. Mr. Gupta, now to what it means to people like me, citizens, in terms of savers and borrowers, what's your sense? Because only some of your rates are linked to the repo rate and there is no repo cut, how will the banking sector behave? I'm not asking for your ALCO's decision. Generally, are banking sector rate cuts going to not come in the next 3 or 4 months?
No, Lata, if you look at it now, you know, most of the loans in the personal segment, the retail loans, particularly the housing loans, they are all linked to the repo rate now, actually. Again, MSME loans also are linked to the repo rate. So there, whatever cuts have happened, so that is being passed on, actually. Okay, and I think from 1st of January, the rates will go down further for the customers. So I think so that way, the transmission as far as that set of customers is concerned, which is on the retail side as well as the MSME, that is already happening. So on the MCLR linked rates, I think that is where the issue has been is. But if you look at the entire MCLR, again, this is formula driven. Okay, and if the banks have 40-45% as CASA deposits, where the rate changes don't really happen, so you know the transmission will always happen to the extent of 60-65% of the rate cuts, actually, unless you are able to cut your deposit rates, which are much larger than the policy rate cuts, actually. I think another important point the governor made today was that through the money market, for most of the large corporates who are raising money from the money market or through the other debt instruments, the full transmission of rates is happening. So it's only, you know, some segment of customers where the rate transmission is not full, but it's happening with the lag. And I think that is what will continue to happen, actually.
Okay. So, you know, aside from all this external benchmarks and all that, just tell me, there is a lot of money with all of you guys, 3 lakh crore is going into the RBI's coffers because you have nowhere to lend it. Do you think sheer demand supply dynamics can push a cost of borrowing down for corporates? Or you think that we are at the end of the fall in rates?
No, I think the lending rates for the corporates are going down. Ultimately, I think from the bank's point of view, how much of money you can put into the RBI repo window also. So I think the banks have been reducing their deposit rates. Ultimately, it's a question of how much each bank can reduce would depend upon their own requirement of funds, actually.
Okay.
So I think the rates cycle, probably, I don't think it's the end of the rate cut cycle. I think it's a pause. It's a question is how long the inflation remains high, actually, and if their estimate is that it may remain up to 5% by the end of March also, so maybe, you know, the rate cuts in the near future may not happen, but subsequently I do assume that the rate cuts will happen, actually.
Okay. Well, I have a lot more questions on the governor's response to a troubled assets relief program, a TARP, to buy real estate assets. I have some questions on whether the market borrowing will be higher come January and how the markets will react. All those questions to my panel in a minute after this break.